To start with, before I give a talk, I would like, as we know, all of us, that our theme is freedom. So I have a subheading which is talking about depression and abuse. So before we go into the Bible, I would like to share with you what happened in the country. 3-4 years back in Zambia, there was a sister in the city of Ndola who suffered from depression. Later on, she came to discover, because she was sick, and she came to discover that she was HIV positive. She disclosed her status before the church, and we are told to pray for her. And when the church prayed for her, God healed her, and all the depression was over. Secondly, 2 years ago, I can give a perfect example, suffered from depression. We used to pray for others, and God used to heal them. Later on, I developed some ulcers in the mouth. And then I said, God, why is it that I have ulcers in the mouth and my lip is swelling? Does it mean you are a God of favoritism? We only heal others, and some we don't heal them? Then I said, oh, well, I'll stop standing before your church. I'll stop moving and preaching because my mouth, the lip is swelling. How am I going to speak? So I suffered for depression for about 2 weeks, and later on I realized that what I had was nothing, but my job is to go ahead and preach the gospel. So God set me free from depression. Praise the Lord. We'll look at the coming out of the children of Israel from the land of Egypt to Canaan. And maybe you may turn with me to the book of Exodus, chapter 3 and verse 7. And the Bible reads, "And the Lord said, I have surely seen the oppression of my people who are in Egypt. I hear their cry, and because of their taskmasters, for I know their sorrows. So I have come down to deliver them out of the hands of the Egyptians and bring them up unto the land of to a good land, a large land, to a land flowing with milk and honey." We all know the story of the Israelites. They were in the land of Egypt. They were in bondage. But at the time that their masters, the supervisors, oppressed on them, abused their rights as human, they abused them, infringed on their rights, they started crying out to God. They remembered the promises of God. They remembered that they belonged to God, a chosen generation, a chosen tribe of Israel. And when they cried to the Lord, they remembered the promises of God. They cried to the Lord, and God heard their cry. And he said, "I've heard the cry of my people that are in Egypt. So I've come to deliver them." Then at that time, let's go to verse 10. "Come now, therefore, and I will send you to Pharaoh, that you may bring my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt." And God decided to call upon Moses and send him to the land of Egypt to deliver them. I'm sure Moses had a lot of excuses. He said he was speechless, was unable to speak. His tongue was somehow hard, and he cannot stand before people. But God told him, he's the one that created human being, and he's the one that can give speech to someone to make him eloquent. So Moses was sent, and Moses agreed with a lot of questions. If people ask me, if the Israelites will ask me, if Pharaoh will ask me, what am I going to say? All sorts of excuses. But God told him, "Moses, I've told you to go to Egypt and deliver my people, for I hear their torment, their cry, their oppression. They are being abused by the Egyptian. Please stand up and go to Egypt and bring my people out of Egypt so that they have freedom." In chapter 14 of Exodus, verse 5, "Now it was told to King Pharaoh that the people had fled, and the heart of Pharaoh and his servant was turned against the people. And they said, why have we done this, that we have let the Israel go from saving us? So he made ready his chariots and took his people with him. So after releasing, after King Pharaoh released the Israelites to go and serve their God, later on God hardened the heart of Pharaoh. And he said, why have we let the Israelites go back to Israel? Please, let's go after them. Let's pursue them. Let's bring them back so that they'll come and serve for us. So King Pharaoh got all the special soldiers, all the commandos that he had, wonderful soldiers, skilled soldiers. They went after the group of the Israelites so that they bring them back into the land of Egypt in order to serve them. But this is what happened. Verse 23, and the Egyptian pursued and went after them into the midst of the sea, all Pharaoh's horses and chariots and his horsemen. When they went, they said, oh, well, there they are going. No, we know there's no bridge, there's no ship, they cannot cross over, so we are going to bring them. If they don't want to come back, we're going to kill them. But the Lord, we know that he's the God of miracles. He told Moses to stretch his hand with the staff on the sea, and the God opened, and the sea and the water was like a wall on the left hand and on the right hand. And the children of Israel went through the dry land, and also the Egyptian followed the Israelites into the dry land. Verse 25, then the Lord said to Moses, stretch out the hand over the sea, that the waters may come back upon the Egyptian and on their chariots and on their horsemen. And Moses stretched out his hands over the sea. And when the morning appeared, the sea returned its full depth while the Egyptians were fleeing so the Lord overthrew the Egyptian in the midst of the sea. Then the waters returned and covered the chariots and horsemen and all the army of Pharaoh that it came into the sea after them. Not so much as one of them remained, but the children of Israel had walked on a dry land in the midst of the sea, and the waters were a wall to them on the right hand and the left hand. So the Lord saved Israel that day out of the hand of the Egyptian, and Israel saw the Egyptian dead on the sea. Thus Israel saw the great work which the Lord had done in Egypt. So people feared the Lord and believed the Lord and his servant Moses. So when Moses obeyed the hand of the Lord and did what the Lord wanted him to do, the Israelites crossed over, and then the Egyptian also followed with the intention of capturing or destroying the Israelites. But the Lord said, Moses, can you lift up your hand over the sea? When Moses obeyed the word of the Lord and the water covered the Egyptian, they wanted to run away from the presence of the Lord, but God overtook them and overthrew them. Most of them died. Not even one survived. And the Egyptian in the morning, when it was in the morning, the Israelites saw all the dead arm of Egypt floating on water. And on that day, the Israelites feared God and also respected Moses as a servant of God. But we know that all of us, we are in bondage. We served sin. We are slaves to sin. But there was a time that God sent his son on the cross of Calvary and died for us. And we are set free from our sin. We are set free from our bondage. Back in Africa, 25th May of this year, most African countries gathered in Ethiopia and in different cities and declared that they were seeing as African Freedom Day, which all the freedom fighters in Africa made up and fought for their freedom. Now, people in the world are calling themselves they are free. They are not free because they are not saved. If they want to be free, they must be born again. As you and I, one day we heard the calling of God. God called us to be saved. As it is saying in the Bible that when the Son of Man sets you free, then you'll be free indeed. Whoever is not set free by the Son of Man is still in bondage, is still a slave. He cannot rejoice, he is not in freedom. So brethren, if there are any new people that have come, that are attending our international convention, this is a message to you, that God is calling you to a freedom. Although you are rejoicing in your good house, your good apartment, but as long as you are not born again, you are not in freedom. God wants you. God wants to set you free. We, all of us, are set free the day we are born again. When the Son of Man sets you free, you'll be free indeed. Indeed, the Lord, on the cross of Calvary, after doing the whole assignment, he said, it is finished. Meaning, bringing freedom to every man. And again, he said, when he was preaching in Israel, he said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. But I want to pick one which says, to set the captive free. We, all of us, were captives, but the Lord had to set us free. So it's up to you, my brother, who has come for the first time. That this is your time. It's your opportunity to be set free. God is in here. All these that you are seeing, that are born again, they are children of God. They are set free. We have freedom, and we can say freedom. At King's Palace, we are singing a song, an item called freedom, and we belong to the king's family. May all the people say, amen.